NHL news tonight, hot off the press. The Canadiens and Blues engage in a five-player trade, and here are the principals. Shayne Corson headed back to Montreal, and Pierre Turgeon following the footsteps of another Montreal captain, Mike Keane, headed back to the Western Conference. Hi again, everyone, and what a difference a week's make. The Maple Leafs, a club mired in mediocrity last week, reeling after four consecutive losses, suddenly bounced back to win three consecutive games, and tonight an opportunity to do what they failed to do all of last season, and that is win four straight hockey games. A rematch as well, the 1993 Western Conference finalists, but the teams they are changing. Only six players in the conference final 3 years ago are back in their respective lineups here tonight. With more on tonight's game and the Leafs' reemergence as of late, let's send it upstairs to Harry Neale.
Well, it's no secret why the Leafs have won three in a row and are playing a lot better than they did in the first 2 weeks of the schedule. First of all, they are not allowing their opponents to outwork them, out-hustle them, or outman them physically. And that is one of the attributes Toronto has to keep ahead in all year if they want to win. They have tightened up defensively from the goalie out, allowed six goals against in their three wins, 23 goals against in the first five games, and the top players have been their top players. Gilmore, Clark, and have gone eight goals in those three wins and 13 points. And when they're scoring, the Leafs have a good chance to win.
And all we have to do is to reflect back on the comments of player Kirk Muller to realize there's a fine line between winning and losing in the NHL.
You know, I think everyone realizes that, you know, to win in this league, you got to give 100%. You got to have the effort. And I don't think it's been there. And, we deserved the 2 days of, hard skating, and if you want to call it punishment in one way, I guess it was.
Well, Kirk, your statement of a week ago about the work ethic here has proved positive. Is that exactly what's turned it around?
Well, I think so. I think the big thing is we're just playing much better as a team, and collectively, and, we're making it easier on ourselves. We're playing smarter, and, we're no different than two-thirds of the teams in the league. We're got to go out and earn your points, and the nice that we do it, we're going to win, and the nice that we don't, we won't, and it's the bottom line, and we did a much better job at it in the past week and feel better about ourselves, and now we just got to continue.
Hasn't been a nickname for a forward line here with Toronto in some time. This Kingston trio doesn't really work. What do you guys call yourselves?
Hopefully successful. Well, it's, it's fun. I mean, you play in your NHL careers, and for the people back home that have three guys from your hometown all in the same line is very rare, and it doesn't happen that often. So they're enjoying it back home, and we just want to go out and help the team, and hopefully we can be an effective line.
All right, let's see how effective they are against the Kings. With more on them, here's Gord Stellick.
For eight seasons beginning in 1988, Wayne Gretzky's immortal status parlayed the Kings into a marquee franchise in pro hockey. They advanced to the Cup Final in 1993, but that was the high point. Now the expectations are much more reasonable. A whole new cast is being assembled. And at the helm is a man who knows all about getting his club back to the brass ring. Larry Robinson's 17-year pro career saw five Stanley Cups, and it's his stewardship that will return the Kings to a place among hockey's elite teams. With a whole new crew in Los Angeles.
Talk about all the changes since 1993. Rob, you're the only guy left from that semifinal series.
Yeah, it's been a big turnaround for me. Last year, missing the whole year, I sat out and watched it happen. And coming in this year, it's a new start, a young team, and Larry's got control, and we're heading the right direction.
What about for yourself? You mentioned that you're healthy again this year, but also the rebuilding process once again when you came close to a Stanley Cup. How was that for you mentally?
Well, it's tough. You get that close and you think that you can just add something to that puzzle for the next year, and all of a sudden we drop back. We missed the playoffs for the last couple of years, and I think the only thing that had to be redone was what has happened and what has taken place, and now we have to start building over and look for that future again.
Nice to see you healthy. Thanks very much for joining us. Back to you, Paul.